Hi everybody, we are on an art meet today and we have some amazing artists with us on board who are logging in slowly. So as all of us log in, maybe we'll introduce ourselves to you. This is a live event where we'll have about 10 artists on board with about 3 to 4 special guests who will inspire us. Their talks.
Good evening, ma'am.
Hi, Tanya. Good to see you.
Same here.
Hey, hi.
So nice to see you. Long time.
I love that that poster behind you.
Oh, really? Yeah. This is my work area.
Wow.
And that's what is inspiring.
Yeah. Yes, it's been very long since we met.
How have you been?
I'm good. How are you? So everybody who is on Facebook Live, we have all the special guests and artists joining us gradually. We have Mr. Vijay Bhatia, who's been with the films, with the television industry. He's an actor and engineer by profession and also a writer. He's known as the king of Doordarshan. He's done about 100 or so films and regional films. He was Bharat in the famous epic Ramayana. And you could introduce yourself, Vijay, more, please.
There's enough that you've already said. So thank you very, very much. Yes.
On the screen, yes.
Yes, I have been an actor by birth. Actually, I was the earliest memories I have is that I've started acting since the age of 4.
Wow.
So that's how it all began. And by the time I was 10 years old, I was pretty much sure that this is what I want to do in life.
Wow.
So that is how it all started. The rest all you've more or less described is what I have been doing and what I have been up to.
Right.
Yeah, writing is a new diversification that has happened.
Right.
Again, coming to expression of art, you know, there are so many different forms.
Yeah.
So you tend to...
Hi, Ali. Can you hear us now?
I can hear you loud and clear, Purnima. How are you?
Thank you so much. So good to see you. And I don't really need to introduce him because he's a very famous actor. Who's acted in... And I remember watching him ever since. And I have a little bit about him.
You're making me sound really old, Purnima, that you remember me from ever since.
Yeah, I'm really older than you. You were as young as me when we were watching your shows. And you're from Karachi, right?
I'm from Bombay. I married a girl from Karachi. So after leaving London, we've now settled in Karachi for the last couple of years. That's right.
Okay. So nice to have you here. And I know you've done a number of films like Mighty Heart, Bond 2, Traitor, to name a few. And he's also appeared in TV series like The Bill, The Strike Back, In the Summers, amongst many others. And we'd like to know a little more about you. Have a few of our special guests on show today. And I'll introduce you all together again, but can we hear?
Sure.
Yeah. Some things about you, please, Ali.
I don't know what to say, really. I'm a mazdoor. Luckily for me, my mazdoori is my passion. And I've been blessed and privileged that the Almighty has kind of... as a life of an actor, given me not so much of a rough ride. Alhamdulillah, all things good. Done a little bit of work that I'm proud of. Done a lot of work that, you know, I've paid the bills.
Yeah.
I got 2 beautiful kids to show for. Got a lovely wife. My mom lives with me. Miss India terribly. And that's about it, pretty much, in a nutshell.
Yeah. SubhanAllah, that's great about you. We have Sajan Narayan coming in. He's also a special guest. Sajan, hi.
Hi, can you hear me?
Hi, Sajan. Sajan is a lawyer, he's a musician, and he's an art lover. And I've known Sajan for a very long time. And he's in the artwork in France in the year 2021. And I hope you're very successful. I wish you good luck, Sajan.
Yeah, thank you so much. It is important to promote Indian artists, in France, because we think that French have the best art and artists.
Thank you. I'd like to have you over. And during the course of the session today, we'll hear you sing a bit of your music and hear your lovely voice.
Okay, that'd be my pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. So we have a special guest. We have Mr. Alan Khan. We have Vijay Gupta, we have Sajan Narayan, and we have Mr. Umal Kaushal, who will be joining us in a bit because he's got some network. Great for everybody, but we've got artists also joining us. We have very talented painters today. And to begin with, let's start with, I can see you, Kumar. So let's start with you. We have Kumar Amlendu Pathak, that's his name. I always call him Kumar. I've known him since the gym where I used to go to. And we've been friends on Facebook, and I used to see his paintings, his sketches actually. He sketches really well. And I've been seeing his colorful paintings recently, doing some canvases. And actually, the entire idea of starting the concept of Art Meet began with painting of his that I saw. It was a beautiful painting, and I said, wow, Kumar, let's all artists get together and display our works, talk about it, and have some special guests invited who will inspire us with art. So Kumar, let's hear it from you.
Yeah. Hi everyone, I'm Kumar Amlendu Pathak. Basically I'm an actor. I've been doing acting since my school life. Started my acting when I was in class, like 3 or 4, I think. I remember as far as I know. Then, when I was in school, I used to draw something. Like, I used to make greeting cards for my teachers, for my parents, my brother. So, the sketching starts from there. Mostly, I like making those greeting cards with my, like, color pencil or something like those color... not the oil paint or watercolor, mostly like pencil work. So the sketches started from there. And then I came to Mumbai after my graduation from Nagpur University, being as an actor for almost like 13 years as a professional actor. I've been doing theater with Gulzar Sahab, theater company. So it's been like almost like 6-7 years I've been associated with Gulzar Sahab and his theater company. Apart from that, like mostly when I'm free, I used to draw sketches. And this during this lockdown, I started doing like, I've been doing sketching. So it's very easy for me doing sketching. So when this lockdown started, so I started getting like, I should learn something new. So what should I do? What should I, like at least I should know something which I can like improve somewhere. So, I just saw a couple of my friends was like posted their previous work, like their paintings, something. So that somewhere inspired me. Let's try that oil color. I went to market. Somehow I managed to get in this initial period of lockdown. Hello. Getting my voice?
Yeah.
So I somehow managed to get this acrylic color set and then brushes. So this is my fourth painting, which I actually after sketching I made this.
Wow.
So this is kind of jackpot. I hit on the first try. I know like most of people like you are a professional painter. Someone asked me, "Are you a professional?" Well, no. This is my first oil color. Now you made it really beautiful, like, and I was like, what to say? I don't know about anything about how to hold the brush actually. like my still hands are like still shake very much. Like the pencil I used to hold, the brush is holding, is really difficult for me. So I made in like this, and this during lockdown I made 3 canvases. This is the first one I hit. Then the second one I made is this Buddha, which is not exactly, I thought the first one was like good, best I made, and the second one like, okay, so now you are coming on the reality side that you have to learn a lot. So this is my second painting, you can see. And the third, which I made like a couple of days back, is this, a very basic. I saw a photograph and like this is my third painting. So these three are my color work. They are still like getting dry. I'll show you some of my sketches, which I am very used to of making. These are the pencil work. The best thing I do, like I always draw a friend. Like whoever are my friend and they want their, I used to give them their birthday gift. Now sometimes every time like someone asks, किसी के birthday में जाना है तो उनको gift क्या दूँ? I am very much, I don't know what to give them. Like जब भी मेरा birthday आता है तो मैं I don't want gifts. So जब देना होता है,
yeah. He wants to say something to you. He wants to say something to you.
Hello.
Kumar, can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, when M.F. Hussain Saab was doing his film Gaj Gamini, you remember that with Madhuri, I think it was.
Yeah.
So set pe he used to, agar kisi ki chai pasand hai, he used to call the spot boy, say, bete bete idhar aa idhar aa. So the spot boy used to go to him, jee sir, say, kagaz la yaar, kuch la, parcha la. And he would draw him a sketch and he'd hand it to him. So similarly, I was teaching my daughter how to play the piano. Well, I wasn't. I was taking her to a teacher who would teach her the piano. Where I used to live in Pali Hill in Bandra. And the teacher, old 80, 90-year-old granny type of Christian lady, very sweet, old, very classic pianist. She and her entire legion of students for 40, 50 years were legendary around Bandra and all the choirs and the, you know, Kamal contests and all of that. Unme se one of the students was MF Saab's granddaughter. So she, on her wall in her small flat in Bandra, had an entire wall done by MF. And she was cursing wow. the day. She's saying, I don't know why I didn't give a paper because abhi agar isko nikalna hai to ye puri rubble aur mitti hogi. And she couldn't find a way to monetize it. So I just thought I'd share that little tidbit with you.
That's really inspiring.
Wow. And I have a small wall at my house, which actually this is, if you guys can see.
Wow.
Where I put my sketches.
Wow.
It has a recent photographs of Irfan Shah and one Charlie Chaplin, and there is one me as well. These are the couple of recent sketches I did. So this is the journey where I mean, I'm not a professional artist in this side. I mean, like painting or sketching. I just do it because I like it, doing it.
Thank you so much. Thanks so much, Kumar. We have Ambika Vij here with us now. Ambika, are you there?
Yes, hi. I'm here. Hello, everybody. Hi. How are you, Purnima?
Where do you live? You live
okay
in Africa?
In Africa, yes. Yeah, we moved to Africa about 25 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah, and now we are settled in South Africa, in Durban.
Oh. Yeah. And I love your paintings. I see them on Facebook. They're amazing, amazing.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, that's, I think it's just,
okay, well, of course, born and brought up in India. I got married and got an opportunity to move out and see the world. So we came to Africa. And we've been here for, as I said, 25 years. So I've done art in school and I did commercial arts as a major in my university. But since then, you know, as we moved and we were trying to make a life and things, so everything else just takes priority. And now that my kids are all grown up, I have more time on my hands. So I thought I shall focus on my passion a bit more and just try and visualize and put through on canvas what, you know, the feelings that I feel and what I want to portray, you know.
Lovely.
Yeah. Yeah. So oils I recently picked up because, you know, that was a subject that I always was so inspired by. You know, the great masters have been just so amazing. You know, they're literally magicians. You go and see their paintings, and their paintings are just out of this world. You know, they're enormous in every sense of the word. Every stroke, every brush mark that they make, you know, it's a story on its own. So that has been a huge inspiration. So oils I picked up a few years ago, and I'm basically self-taught in that, but I'm really enjoying my journey. It's been really nice, really interesting.
I read somewhere that you were very inspired by your mom. Did she paint?
Yes, my mom was such a creative lady, my God. She painted, she used to do these huge cross-stitch paintings. And you know, she was like amazing. She used to do this art called the Kundalini art. And sadly, I don't have any of her paintings with me, but you know, it was just amazing. It was basically scribbling of lines, and then she would pick out images from there. And it was really, really amazing. So that's what I was, you know, inspired by while growing up. And, you know, and I think art and colors and figures and, you know, the moods, it's just amazing. Yeah, it just tells you so much. Tells you so much about a person. I think for us artists, you know, we put ourselves into each canvas that we paint. You know, it's a mirror image of us at some point. You know, a feeling that we have felt at a moment, you know, what just comes out. You know, you plan something, you know, you can plan whatever. But if you're really into that piece, if you're really feeling what you're doing, it just comes out on that canvas. And first, you know, people who see, they can read something into it. And it's all about connecting with the person who's looking at your artwork as well, because they need to feel something in that piece as well. So, yeah.
Can we see some of your works, please?
Sorry?
Can we see some of your works? Are they around you?
Yeah, I just kept a couple of pieces. I don't have too many things. I didn't put out a lot of stuff. So I can show you something now. So this piece that I'm presenting to you now, it touches on the vividity of dreams. So this was a piece I did for an exhibition. So they had a theme to this exhibition called Same Bed, Different Dreams. So this was something where I went out of my comfort zone, and let me just put it on for you. I hope you see it. Okay.
Wow.
So, yeah. So here, so as I said, it is the vividity of dreams, conscious and subconscious. Some we realize and some we keep deep down into the realms of our minds. The fluidity of feelings, passions, aggression, etc., are all a bubbling pot in our subconscious. We all want love and connection with someone special, and all the intermingling of dreams is a chain reaction. Same or different, you decide.
Wow, that's lovely. Lovely, Ambika. Truly nice.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
That's oils?
That is oils, yes. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
And thank you. And I have two pieces here that I did for a wall for my son's house. So these are a bit bigger pieces, as you can see. So these are two canvases. Yeah.
You're fond of portraits. Yes, I've seen them on your Insta page.
I just love the human touch. You know, I just love feelings, and you know, I think that's what really ticks me. You know, that's what gives me the inspiration. You know, what that mood, that feeling, that instance of, you know, you being somewhere and not knowing that you are there, but somebody just picks up on that feeling and they work on it. And I think that's what it is, you know. For me, the human touch and the reality of it is very important. I think I see a lot of myself into that. So, yeah.
Thank you, Ambika. Thanks so much. Really nice to hear.
Thank you so much. Yes. Thanks. I do have an Instagram account where I have a lot more paintings which are up. So I would love for everybody to follow.
Everybody, we'll put down everybody's Insta account.
Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thanks. What do our special guests feel about the paintings that they have seen till now? Can I have a few words from you, please? Thank you.
Sorry, are you asking me?
Anybody, any of Alay or Vijay or Sajan, anybody, please?
Yeah, I think it's great. And if you feel passionately about something, then you must pursue it. You know, I'm glad to see that people are keeping themselves well busy. And also now with the internet and social media, it's so easy to get your stuff seen and get appreciated. And here we are. I was just thinking to myself that it's so nice to be able to be a part of a conversation, Purnima, thanks to you, where we're connecting with someone sitting in Durban and I am here in Karachi. Where are you at the moment? Are you in Bombay?
Bombay, yes.
Right. So it's so fantastic that we're all sitting in real time in our individual little spaces, but actually getting a chance to communicate. So that in itself is brilliant.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Vijay, please, over to you.
Yeah, I would like to continue on the same thought. I'm really happy, glad to be sharing space with such people. And I'm so glad that I'm connecting with people from all over the world. And Ali, especially, I've been fascinated about Pakistan also. So that's a very rare thing that people say from India, but I am actually. And
sorry to cut your conversation since you brought up the subject. I'll just quickly take a minute of your time. I got married. I brought all my friends from Bombay to Karachi. So 30-40 log hum log badi toli mein aaye na. And I collected everyone's passport from Bombay, sent them by courier to Delhi. Delhi mein sabke visa lage. Direct flight hua karti thi Bombay Karachi. That's how I got married, because I came here with Jagjit Singh and Farida Khanum to do a concert, and that's how I met my wife. Anyway, to cut a long story short, all my friends came here, and we had 4-5 days of festivities and a party at the beach, and Rahat Fateh Ali Khan sang and blah 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 at the Qawwali and jo bhi hua. But by the time everyone went back, they had such a different perception of the country, the people. I think more the people and the kind of lifestyle here. And everyone, funnily enough, jo bhi India mein rehte hain, everyone, whether they wish to or not, have a connect with this country. That goes back. And so that curiosity is lovely, you know, is absolutely great.
Yeah, just coming back to it, I come from the same town as Jagjit Singh ji, that is Sri Ganganagar, Rajasthan. So my parents, everybody is from there, and I was born there and brought up in Bombay. So that's a little bit of it. Coming back to the artist point, amazing. I'm nobody to judge your artwork, but still what looks good is good for me as a layman. And Kumar, especially if you are untrained and this is what you are doing when you don't know art and drawing and sketching, I'm waiting to see when you learn and what piece of art will come out after that. And Ambika also, the first painting I saw was a little abstract for me, and I couldn't really, reading art is also an art, and I'm not that big an artist. But yeah, the human faces and all that was pretty fascinating. I really liked that. And I shall keep dropping into the conversation as and when. I think Sajan sir should be.
That coming from someone who is known as the king of Doordarshan is quite amazing. Thank you.
So that's only something that people keep saying. I consider myself nobody. And art is a journey which you keep on continuing throughout life.
Thank you. Thank you. Hi, Sajan.
Yeah, hi. So I want to really compliment. So first, Kumar, I thought that first artwork is, if you didn't say anything about yourself or your background, I would have complimented that art and said that it's from someone who has to be a guru, because it's a very powerful and beautiful, composition. And my son's name is Shiv. So there's a, real connect. Just show it again. I want to see it once more.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, beautiful.
My laptop has gone down.
Okay. No, that's okay. So that's fantastic. And Ambika, that first painting that you showed, I was just thinking about, where in France, I should first present, because in my exhibition that I'm planning, we're planning to do it in Paris, Bordeaux and Marseille. And, okay. The French, it seems to me that they love colors. And they love, this kind of creativity. So, definitely that would appeal. But your other point about, the human connect is also important, because, that real character sometimes is quite remarkable. And the quality of your work is very impressive. So, and I've, of course, like Purnima, been looking at your paintings over a while and appreciating them.
Thank you so much. Thanks. We have Gargi Mona. Is that Mona?
Yeah, hi.
I've seen you, and she's an art lover and art enthusiast like Sri Moy, and they're both into holistic healing as well. And she's a very dear friend of mine, and so is Sri Moy. And it's a great honor to have them on the show as well.
Thank you, Purnima.
Thank you. Okay, so now who should I call? Gargi, are you there? Hi, Gargi. He's an artist, a painter. Hi, Gargi, can you see me?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Sorry, it was on mute. Hey, hi, everyone. So I sat down here without, I would say much confidently, but being in presence of such great artists from different fields, it's like overwhelming. Hi, can you all hear me?
Yes, we can. Yes.
So it's like my journey has just begun. I mean, initially when I was very, very small, I used to live in Kolkata, and my uncle Mausaji used to write me letters in the form of pictures. I mean, he was a painter. He used to write me stories, which my mom used to say you would understand. So I could actually relate to the story, what he's trying to say. And, so it was a very novel idea, I guess, at that time. And so that's how I got into art. It stayed with me, and in school, in till about college days, I used to kind of, whenever I had the time in between studies, I'm being the only child of my parents, there were a lot of spaces where I used to feel lonely. So that was to be, that gap kind of was filled in by art, by paintings. I get transported, I still do, into a different zone. So that's kind of a starting of the journey. Wherever I am, whatever distance I've traveled, I am always kind of learning. So in between, as Ambika said, got into life, got married, had a child. I used to initially about, in the first few years of marriage, I used to paint the walls and the doors and the windows, whatever I would get in my free time. But then that got lost. Now, when my daughter is now in the 12th grade and she's grown up, I find myself again with a lot of time, lot of, energy is left, but I don't know how to consume. So I was trying to explore various various, you know, ways. So then I landed up on, you know, kind of trying to go back to my passion of painting. And then I got to, enrolled with one lady who teaches, you know, acrylic, because I had never done acrylic before. Whatever I had done is water painting mostly. So that's how, you know, I've started again 2-3 years back. There's nothing much to say. I have done very few pieces till now, because the learning process is very slow, and I love to go slow because I want to kind of take it all in and not like in bits and pieces. I would like to learn it thoroughly. So that's how it has been till now.
Can you see some of your artworks, Gargi?
Yes. So one of them, if you can see, I'll show you. This is the, you know, this is what.
Look at our work.
So this is what I have. You know, this is the one actually you saw, Purnima. I was...
You were in the midst of it, right?
I was in the midst of it, yes. Nice. So this is one. Then, though this is a copyrighted picture, but I felt like painting it. So I'm not going commercial on this. So I decided to do this. And this is how it has been. Is it visible?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is one more. Then I've been kind of very fond of owls. I have a lot of owls in my own house as well. So I did this afterwards. And this one again is inspired by a real life candle stand that I had in my house. I took a picture of this and started, you know, copying it. And very recently, during this last 2-3 weeks, I have all kind of done this one. So this is about some of my, I have another few pieces here and there. So this is what I have been doing, and I'm sure I must be, you know.
Gargi, can you tell us what the first one is about?
The first is the first. I mean, that this one.
First one that you showed us. The first.
Yes. This is a scene from a, you know, forested land. Mm-hmm. You know, which is like with leaves and it is a time of the day where, I guess, the just you can say it is the. It must be in the evening. So the light is slightly bright at places, but mostly dark otherwise.
What's the medium there? Is it acrylic or oil?
This is it. All is acrylic. So I've started exploring acrylic last 3 years. So, yeah.
Very nice.
Not that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Paul, one of the younger artists on board here. So let's have Ananya. Are you there? Can you unmute Ananya, please?
Hi,
Ananya. I can't see you.
Yeah, just a second.
Hi.
Hi. My name is Ananya, and I'm 14 years old. I'm from Raipur. And when I was hardly 3 to 4 years, my mom started sending me drawing classes just for leisure. And then gradually it started become my hobby. And whenever I used to be sad, I used to draw. It used to bring me happiness. And during this lockdown period, my interest in drawing gradually grew deeper. And I tried different mediums like acrylic, watercolor, mandala. I was inspired by different artists, and I could, like, I used to express my feelings through drawing. I'm not so good at expressing, so like I just used to express my feelings through drawing. This is something I made. Like, I was inspired by the society.
Thoda upar lo.
Can you see it?
A little higher, please.
Yeah.
Okay. I was inspired by the society that still people are not comfortable talking about this topic. So I just tried creating awareness. And now I'm like, I just practice, and this year I gave my diploma in art. And now I've decided that I should do this as a career because I'm really into it. That's it. And I can show you some of my works.
Just lift them a little higher, huh, so we can see them.
Like, this is a cartoon character I drew.
Wow.
Very sweet.
Very beautiful, Ananya. Very beautiful.
Thank you. These are some of the works I did in utensil. Like,
awesome. Truly awesome.
Painting. And I tried acrylic also, so I can show you. This is like what I tried. This.
Lift it higher.
Lift it up.
Wow.
This is not complete. I'll show you more. This is what, like, from nature, the cloud.
Raise it up. Raise it up. Yeah. Okay.
I used to click photos and then I used to copy the scenery.
Wow.
This is also some of my drawings.
Wow.
That's it.
That's really nice.
Very good.
Very nice.
Excellent.
Excellent. Ananya, good job.
Thank you. Good work, Ananya. Good, good.
So what do our special guests have to say about these artists that we just saw?
All of them are very, very good. Only one thing that I need to tell Ananya. Ananya, you are too young to feel sad. One thing you said, that whenever you are sad, you get to drawing. Please be happy always. And anyways, you're doing a great job. And
thank you.
You're too young. Long, long way to go. All the very best from me and from everybody else here. And good luck.
Thank you.
But on a different note, Ananya, I love the way you think. And I'm happy that there are such youngsters of your age who have such a mature way of thinking. So maybe not too sad and morose, but keep the intensity to your work and to your life. Lots of love and lots of luck for your future.
Thank you so much.
Sajan? Is Sajan there?
Yeah, yeah. I shut my video.
Yeah, I see that, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Very, very beautiful. I was appreciating how young she is, and with the talent, you know, it's remarkable. And I think you need a lot of encouragement. And also, you know, the other suggestion, because of how I grew up next to Triveni Kala Sangam in Delhi, and going to meet artists and seeing exhibitions, is exposure. So, you know, the younger you are and the better exposure that you get over time, it's really going to help to develop as an artist.
Thank you.
Hi, Sajan.
Hi.
Hi, Kumar this side.
Hi, Kumar. Yeah.
Sorry, but that laptop has gone disconnected. So you want to see it again?
Yeah. Please. Yeah.
Yeah. This is the first one I made.
That's the one I was saying. Yeah, yeah. Very, very beautiful. But you know, it's not an ordinary composition. It's a very special. Very special artistic element in it. Congratulations.
I don't know. I just hit the jackpot on the first try.
Very good. Very
kind
good.
Of. I know it's a kind of like on the first try you got something good. And this is the second one which I made.
I saw that. Very nice. Very good. Very good. Very, very serene and peaceful. Very, very nice. It's one of the kind of...
The second time I was so lucky.
I know, but like no, but it's one of the kinds of paintings and the composition and colors that you can look at, you know, for a longer period and meditate. Thank you so much. Very good.
Thank you so much.
Riya, are you there? Can you unmute me?
Yes, ma'am, I'm there.
Hi, Riya.
Hi, I'm fine. Just a second, let me switch on my video. Am I visible to everyone?
Yes.
Hello, Riya.
Hello, everyone.
I love the piece that you had written there.
Look,
Very nice.
Thank you so much.
You can read it out to us.
I actually, unfortunately, don't have it right now. Wait, I have it on my phone, maybe at the end. Okay. About the art, I'm going to be honest. Before coming here on this video call, I was a bit intimidated, right? Because I'm 14. I've been into art for around 3 years now, or four. I initially, when I saw the group, I was like, oh my God, there's so many great artists. How am I going to, present myself? But now that I'm here, I feel really, really glad, because when you see the actual people who have made the artworks, like Ambika ma'am and Kumar sir, I felt so inspired, not intimidated. I felt inspired. I want to be in that sort of exposure, talk with such great artists so that I can improve on myself, right? I initially got into art because of Harry Potter. I was a hardcore Harry Potter fan, and one day I thought, why not try drawing one of my favorite characters? And so I did, and I liked it. But I was in sixth grade, mein, you're basically too young, right, to think about a career or anything. But then what kept me going, in the terms of art, what made me hold on to art wasn't Harry Potter, of course. It was that when I do art, it's my piece, you see. It's something that I've made. It gives me a sense of originality. And honestly, originality is something that I really hold on to in all aspects of life. So when I make something, it's not anyone else's. It's my hard work, my patience, my creativity, see. And sounding a bit narcissistic, but that is what gives me, the sense of originality that I long for. Well, I've mostly been into sketches, but this was the first canvas that I've ever made.
Wow.
I don't know. Wow. Nice. So, it's acrylic.
Yeah, nice lighting. Great.
Amazing.
Beautiful.
Nice lighting.
Really beautiful.
Thank you. So, this was the first
What medium is that?
That is acrylic. It was acrylic. After that, I, picked up more sketching. I got more into sketching. This is my sketchbook, as you can see. During the lockdown, I did not have a canvas. So I got really fed up and ended up painting my sketchbook, the cover. just something good to look at when you open the sketchbook. Wow. The sketchbook itself is a painting. But this is one of my most recent sketches. I don't know if it's that well, visible in the lighting. I could send a picture on the group, but so that's one of my sketches.
Is that supposed to be a self-portrait?
Not exactly. I don't look that good, I'm afraid.
No, you're pretty.
Thank you. And then this, again, when finally the lockdown period got, it got ended, it ended. And then I could finally go out and buy a canvas. I ended up painting
Fantastic.
This.
Fantastic. Wow. Beautiful.
Wow. Thank you.
This
is beautiful.
You see it? Yeah. So, and art for me is, at first it just started out as a hobby, a stress buster, But now that I think about it, I feel like it would be marvelous if I could be one of you many talented folks here and pick up art as an actual career, you see. Well, art, earlier now, around when I was in, I'm currently in ninth grade. When I was in around eighth and seventh, I got a bit demotivated. Why? Because a lot of people, they criticized me, And then I started comparing myself to more experienced artists. But when I thought about it, I discovered that is not how you get better. You get better by practicing on your own self, by bettering your art, not comparing it to other people. And that was something very important that I realized to, keep moving forward. So I'd like to say, even though I'm just 14, if any of you are ever you ever find yourself comparing your works to someone else's, don't do that. Work on yourself and you will get marvelous. That's it.
Excellent.
Well said. Well said. Very profound.
I'm learning so much from you. I mean, age doesn't matter.
You know, this is exactly why I was here. Exactly. To get inspired.
Fantastic.
Amazing.
And you know, Ria, I gave one of my AirPods to my 11-year-old daughter who was standing on the side watching you. She likes to paint and she's not showing her sketchbook. But it was really inspiring for her to listen to that. So thank you from a personal point of view as well.
My pleasure.
Thank you so much. Who do we have and who do we call? Triveni. Hi, Triveni Mahajan. Hasrat, please unmute Triveni Mahajan. Thank you.
Purnima.
Hi.
Yeah, Ali.
Purnima, I got to go, Purnima. I'm sorry, but I need to leave. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And lots of love to everyone. Great meeting everyone.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. God bless.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Hi, guys. I'm Triveni. Purnima and I have grown up together. So that's our connection.
Yeah,
same colony, same school, and that's the connection. Ambika as well. So that's a modernite connection we three have. Though we three are in different directions. So what I did after school was I got into a CA. I'm a qualified chartered accountant. But then I didn't want to continue the rest of my life with this. So I did goldsmithing. So I'm a qualified jewelry designer and also an enamelist. So what I do basically is jewelry as well as enameling. And I don't know if you can see the pictures behind me enameling. I'm going to show you a close up. So I don't know if how many of you are aware of enameling.
Not really sure.
Okay. So enameling is by and large a fired art. So we take crushed glass and pigments and we work on metals like copper, gold, silver, meenakari, like you said, like meenakari we had. The same, but we work on a very different unconventional way. So we do work with steel plates and copper. That's the cheapest medium to work with, but yet not so cheap. But so we work with copper, do a little bit of metal smithing on it, cleaning and all that. And then we put our crushed glass and then we fire it in a kiln at approximately 900 degrees Fahrenheit minimum, in 900 to 1100. So something like ceramics, but ceramic works on clay. We work on metal. A lot of people confuse ceramics with enameling, which is not the same thing. So to start off with, I'll show you a couple of the small pieces which I've done, which will give you an idea. So these are these small bulls. I don't know if you can see them.
Yeah, we can.
This is on copper. And can you see these?
Yes.
So these are two-sided. It's more of a 3D. These are more of a sculpture. So this is, if you see a close-up, this is black enamel. These are crushed glass. And we have opaque as well as vitreous. So this is one thing I'm showing you. This is done on copper because you can kind of work with copper and you can make whatever you want, shapes and everything. So this is one thing. Then I'll show you these paintings which I've done. I do abstracts more and I'm very spiritual in my way of thinking. So I don't pre-plan my pieces. So can you see these?
Yeah, it's beautiful.
And this is the other one. This is more of the flower of the... And then these are on my walls, so I'm kind of showing you whatever best angle I can get.
They're gorgeous.
So these are one which I've done. Then I went to Hungary and we worked there. So those, they have big industrial kilns. So we worked on pieces which are 2 feet by 1 feet, 1.5 feet. So these are the, are you able to see them?
Yes.
Yeah.
So these are all fired. There's nothing, you can't work. So you can do a lot of layerings. You can do up to 30, 40 firings, but you need to fire. This is nothing like acrylic or something. So you can do a lot of layering. You can change. But then after that, there's a fatigue factor which comes in the metal. So it kind of loses shapes and stuff like that. So that is another thing. Then we do a lot of bowls. Like her, I also love, like Gargi, I'm also an owl fan. So I have also done owls. I have a lot of owls in my house as well. So this is what I've done, which is
beautiful.
So these, the life of these pieces is up to 1,000 years. The colors and everything, as long as you don't drop them and you don't chip them, because then the glass kind of coat chips and that's it. Then you have to repair them and kind of those. So Chinese and the European countries are doing a lot of contemporary art on, and you know, jewelry and bangles and artifacts and sculptures. India, it's still a very traditional meenakari, restricted only to your jewelry. And some of the schools in India now teaching enameling as a professional field, but not really. It's a very expensive, time-consuming kind of a field, because you need the infrastructure to kind of work on it. So it's not everybody's cup of tea, but, and it's also not accepted by the mainstream artists as a, you know, a medium for fine arts. Let's put it that way. So that's me.
It's really beautiful. It's so unique. I mean, it is really unique, and I'm sure not everybody can do it, as you said.
It's a lot of work. It's like sara time tum bartan manjte ho na, it's like continuously you have to do the manjoing the bartans, because you have to clean it every time you kind of do. You can't have oxidization. So it's like a constant work. And I think it's passionate. If you're passionate about anything, you can kind of go ahead and do it. So it's,
of course,
it's a kind of a calling. It's a, I connect. It's like meditation for me. So for me, it works in those ways. So I don't pre-plan my thing. Whatever the mind works, wherever direction it goes, I kind of start making.
Thanks, Rivini.
Thank you so much. I got to know about a new form of art.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thanks.
Such beautiful pieces you have made. My God. Very beautiful.
Thank you.
Neerja, are you there? Hi, Neerja. Hasrat, please unmute Neerja.
Hi, there is some network issue. If I switch on the video, the entire thing just disconnects. So I don't think I'll be able to share anything. Let me try. Let me just give me a moment.
Let me call Sajan back again. Sajan.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Sajan, have you here? So Sajan is a great musician as well, and he sings very beautifully. Sajan, is it too much to ask you to sing us a little song?
No, it's my pleasure. I love singing. I have no issues. Okay, then you have to hold for a second.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, I just needed to adjust the volume. One second. Okay. So this is a song called Annie's Song by John Denver.
You fill up my senses like a night in the forest, like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like a sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses, come fill me again. Come let me love you Let me give my life to you. Let me drown in your laughter. Let me die in your arms. Let me lay down beside you. Let me always be with you. Come, let me love you. Come, love me again. Let me give my life to you. Come, let me love you. Come, love me again. Fill up my senses like a night in the forest, like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like a sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses. Come fill me again.
Wow.
Brilliant, brilliant.
Superb,
brilliant.
Awesome. Superb.
Beautiful. Arjun, thank you.
Thank you.
Amazing. Okay, let me call up Alicia. Alicia, are you there?
Yes.
I can't see you. Yeah, hi.
Okay, so good evening, everyone. Firstly, I would like to thank Poonam ma'am for giving us all this opportunity to interact with each other on this platform. So, drawing and painting has been a hobby since taking proper guidance. Now I draw quite pretty well and good. So, recently I finished my elementary exam. And now I'm preparing for my intermediate. So some of the forms of art, what I do, the African art, the yin yang art, and the paper mache art also as well. So I'm kind of fond of all these different types of arts. And all these arts are done through the mediums like acrylic and watercolors. Mostly I do all these arts in acrylic. So yeah, and I would love to share with y'all some of my art forms. So actually mandala is a Sanskrit word. Which means a magic circle. I really love this form of art because it gives me a peace of mind, and also I feel very satisfied while doing it. So yeah, that's about this mandala art. Next is this canvas. So this canvas relates my love for nature and also the waterfall over here, as you all can see. I really love waterfalls and I've portrayed it on this canvas. So I've done this canvas in the shades of pink, purple and dark blue. And I really love the nature and I love to draw nature. So, and the next is this sketching. It is just a random sketch. Actually, good at sketching, but during this lockdown period, I thought, why not improve on my sketching skills? So yeah, I've done this. This is a sketch. And then I've done one more canvas. So this canvas shows us the stages of life. Like this is the youth, and this is the old age, and this is the death. So yeah, that's it. This shows the stages of life. And yeah, I am looking forward to learning a lot from y'all, because life never.
I think some network issue happened. So Vijay, what do you feel about the works that you've seen? In between, I know there was some network issue and...
Yeah, lots of network issues. I had to log out, log on.
Yeah.
But then that's the way technology works. And yeah. We are getting used to it now. This is the way it's going to be.
Grateful we can be in touch otherwise.
Yeah. As far as art is concerned, amazing. I'm... overwhelmed with what I've been seeing, and especially these young girls, and not just art, the way they think and the kind of maturity they show that reflects in their art also. So great. And obviously, and of course, the other other artists also. I'm really, really happy to see. The reason why I was here was to get some inspiration. I've been looking for some inspiration the past couple of days, working on something new. So this sounded like a completely different kind of a platform, and I'm so glad you asked me to be a part of this. And I have found quite some inspiring thoughts and lots of motivation to get into something new again. And whenever you think you're going to close down this meeting, I would like to have 2 minutes. And if everybody follows Hindi, I would like to share something that I wrote.
I have to ask you to share one of your writings.
Okay, then I can go immediately.
Don't switch off after that.
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't switch off after that. Until unless technology is with me, I am with you guys.
Yeah.
Okay, here it goes. बड़े दिनों से कुछ यादें ज़हन पर दस्तक देती हैं. दौड़कर पहुंचता हूं मैं, पर चेहरा कोई नजर आता नहीं. जोड़ती है मुझे सबसे जो डोर, वो कभी नजर आती नहीं. क्या यही है वो जिसे रिश्ता हम कहते हैं? कब, किससे, कैसे जुड़ जाता है नहीं पता. बिखर कर टूट कब जाए ये भी नहीं किसी को पता. सोचता हूं ये मैं अक्सर, लेकिन समझ में नहीं आता है कि रिश्ता कब टूट जाता है. चलते चलते जब परछाई से मन घबराता है. बिस्तर में सिमटे रहते थे कभी, आज वही बिस्तर छोटा पड़ जाता है. यादें थी कभी दरमियां, अब तेरी मेरी चीजों को बांटना पड़ जाता है. घंटों बातें होती थी, अब सामना हो जाए तो दिल किनारा कर लेता है. शायद ऐसा ही होता है जब रिश्ता कोई टूट जाता है. दोस्त ऐसे भी थे कि परिवार तुम्ही में नजर आता था. न मिलते कभी हम तो दिन पूरा नहीं हो पाता था. रिश्ता अपनी दोस्ती का तो हर दीवार से ऊंचा था. यह फकत समय काटने का ये एक जरिया था. फोन पर आज भी मैं तेरा कॉल ढूंढता हूं, लेकिन रिसेंटली डायल्ड नंबर जब सिर्फ एक कॉन्टैक्ट बनकर रह जाता है, हाँ शायद रिश्ता तब टूट जाता है. आंखें नम हो जाएं जब ऐसे कि तस्वीरों का हर चेहरा धुंधला पड़ जाता है. रिश्ता तब टूट जाता है. रिश्ता तब टूट जाता है.
थैंक यू.
बहुत खूब.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू. थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू.
वी लॉस्ट नीरजा, हैव वी? I think I can't see her.
Yeah, I think she.
Trying to, you know, get her video working. That's what I'm feeling.
Tanya, can we hear it from you now? Please unmute Tanya. Yeah.
Hello, everybody.
Hi.
My name is Tanya. I'm 16. And basically, I'm a musician. Singing is something that I adore. When it comes to painting, I've not done any classes. I'm not a professional from any way. But there are factors that inspire me a lot. Like when I look at the setting sun or rain or flowers, I feel nature is trying to speak, trying to say something. And those are the aspects that I pick up. And then I transform that into some kind of art. So basically, I write poems or songs or some kind of musical pieces. But yeah, acrylics was something I started right now in the month of, from the month of March. It was like my lockdown hobby that turned out to be extremely good. My pencil sketching began in the year of 2016. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So yes, this was one of my pen sketchings. And as I said, nature inspired. Yeah, this was it. And this is a dream catcher. And yeah, just scrolling on Pinterest gave me some mandala and zentangle ideas. So yeah, this was one of them. Yours? Yeah, so this was pretty much it. And leaving all this apart, I really enjoy writing poetry on various topics. Because when you want to convey a message, not everyone always listens to normal speeches or something like that. But when it comes to an artist, I think poetry, singing, paintings, acrylic, these are like methods which actually help you to pour out your soul in various forms. So yeah, that's pretty much about me.
So you said you're a musician, right, Tanya?
Yes, ma'am, you're saying? I lost you.
A musician?
I?
Are you musician. A musician?
Yeah, yes, ma'am, I'm a professional musician. I give...
Or do you play an instrument?
Ma'am, I sing as well as I play the keyboard.
Wow. Can we hear something from you?
You want me to sing right now?
Why not?
Okay. I would choose the song My Heart Will Go On from Titanic. Okay, so yeah, every night in my dream I hear you, I feel you, every time I know you, oh, oh. All across the distance and spaces between us, you have come to show you, oh, near or wherever you are, I believe that the heart does go on once more. You open the door and you're here in my heart, and my heart will go on there.
Wow.
Thank you.
Wow. Amazing. Very amazing. Nice.
All the best for your future. All the best.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay, so
so nice. Wow.
We have somebody left here. Who do we have left? Has everybody spoken? Alicia, yes. What about we connected Hasra to someone called Once, right? That was Huma. I can't see that One Plus anymore.
Yeah, I think that person is left out.
Yeah, she was having issues in connectivity. What about Jaya? I saw her sitting in between. Okay, so we are waiting for Jaya because I saw her name flash here. And I saw that One Plus Huma also flash here. Jaya saying she's unable to join, but she's trying again. In the meanwhile, let me talk a bit about what I've been painting now, off and on. I thought I'd speak in the end, but it's okay. So basically, I started when I was about 13 years of age. And that's when I did my first canvas, which is out of pleasure and nothing else really. And it was, I remember it was big. It wasn't a small canvas. This is about 3 feet. And it was, I always like painting something called abstracts, you know, because it fascinates me. So I painted one with the oils and canvas, and it was this little ship, which was my idea of a little ship passing through a narrow valley. And I remember it being displayed in my parents' house in their lobby for almost 20 years, and as if it was a masterpiece. So it was the first ever painting I ever made. And ever since then, I've been enjoying painting off and on. I was into a meditation and reading profession for almost 20 years. But apart from that, wherever we got transferred, my husband was in a transferable job. So wherever we moved, I always held my painting shows. So I dabbled a lot with crushed glass and glass, and glass paints. And I made a lot of abstracts and couple paintings on glass. And I remember Sajan's mom, the very famous painter, Mrs. Manju Narayan, and I had displayed my first glass painting at her studio in Delhi called Studio 55. And after that, I moved over to Paris again, and I was making many oil paintings. And now I have a couple of paintings here to show. Lately, I've been dabbling with knife art, so that's acrylics. And acrylics, a knife work on acrylics. These are the miniature ones that I'm showing you here. So that's a miniature knife art. That's the Evercore.
Nice, very nice.
Then we have the monk here. That's the monk. This is also done with knife. And
lovely.
We have the ballerina, all knife work. Instead of a brush, I've used knife strokes here. So done with acrylics and knife. Okay, then we have. It's been raining and pouring. This inspires me. I don't know how clearly you can see the effects of the
now. We can.
Okay. So, this is inspired by Rumi, the poet. This is a Sufi, a whirling dervish. Nice. I have some big canvases. I don't know if they will fit in here. But that's a knife art again. Performance, and this is the start of the performance, and this is the peak of the performance. To me, it's more like beautiful performance, actually. Then I don't know how to show these bigger canvases because I don't really have any ones here. This is one of the last few works that I did, and this
very nice.
It's liberation to me.
Lovely.
And I have which is one of my favorite works, actually. I don't know how visible it will be. But this is all to do with element water. I'm very inspired by the element is signifying the flow of water. I'm sorry, but I don't have small canvases to show you. So this is various textures. This is oils, there's wood art, and there's knife art. I have a really big canvas. I don't think I'll get it. So let's not talk about it. But so I've been doing it. It always fascinates me. It's one of my loves. And I, every time I just go back. There's no way that I just go back to it. It's a pleasure to take that. It sort of revives me again. And this lockdown has been a great phase for me that way, because it's helped me inspired to keep doing it. So that's about it. So Sajan, can we hear from you, please? Sajan, are you there?
Yeah. Very, very impressive. So, you know, it's great that you are able to work on these big canvases, because it's normally a great challenge. And the other thing is that, you know, the colors are outstanding. They're very vivid, and the compositions are very, very interesting, because, you know, that creativity that's coming through, that's normally what one looks for. So I'm very happy to see your work. Also, knife art is bound to be difficult, so, you know, I'm trying to imagine.
I enjoy it. To me, it's easier than the brush now.
I know. Yeah, but, you know, the first time that I've heard of something similar to knife art would be, you know, from Rameshwar Bhutta. That's because he would work in a reverse manner. He would paint multiple coats and then he'd strip color or coats off. And that is how the effect of, you know, three-dimensional, you know, art came through in his paintings.
Amazing artist.
So he's famous. So luckily we grew up, you know, knowing him and Mrs. Bhutta, Shobha Bhutta and all. And everyone else, very talented artists at Triveni, thanks to my mom going there. So she started around 1980. So we've been going to Triveni ever since, and I'm in touch with all the artists there. So it's, you know, fascinating. But well done. Very impressed. Very impressed.
Thank you. We just tried to connect, but it's getting disconnected. And I don't know. I think Hasrat would be good. Gaya is also trying to connect. Let me just ask them in case they are able to connect. Fine, or
I think Jaya also left.
She was disconnecting all the time, so she couldn't help it. Meanwhile, let's hear it from our special guest, whatever it is that we have there. JN. Hasrat, please unmute JN. Hasrat? Unmute Vijayan Sarkar.
I've already asked to unmute, but he's muted himself.
Yeah.
Vijay is muted himself?
Yes.
Okay, I think Neerja is really trying to connect, but she's unable to. So let's, that's it. Let's wind up, because they can't connect. So today we'll have an art meet again, hopefully in some time. And then we'll connect with those who were unable to connect today. So thank you all the artists for being here today. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, Mom, for inviting us. It was a great experience.
Thank you. Thank you, all your art lovers, Shri Moy.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma, thank you so much. The fact of the matter is, after seeing so much of talent and artistic skills, I'm feeling very complex ki maine kya kiya life mein. But it's amazing what I saw. I mean, and the young kids, my God, they are so wise. The way they talk, my God.
You are never late.
Yeah. All I used to do when I was a kid is draw, scribble cartoons. That's all I used to do.
Even I started sketching like a cartoons only first. You can do it right now.
Yeah, you were saying
there are girls, there are artists who are 14, 16, 17 years, and I'm thinking at 30 years, I recently started doing oil painting. If I would have started at 16, today might be a different kind of artist.
No, but you are very good.
So it's never late.
Very good, Kumar.
Yeah, you are very good. So thank you, Purnima, so much. And thank you. I got to see so many paintings after such a long time because I don't get a chance to go to any exhibition and see it. So it was a
hopefully delight. Next time when we will have this kind of meeting, we will see some of the painting behind that wall, which is empty.
He's a very talented.
Your own.
I am planning to call Gargi home so that she can paint that wall.
That will be the easiest thing you can do, but still, you can have.
You sing beautifully. Should I catch you today to sing for us?
Yeah, I would love to hear that.
Are you there?
Please do that.
Can you hear me? Boy? Can you hear you sing?
You're telling Kumar, no? He cannot hear.
No.
You're telling me. I'm not able to hear it.
You're telling me.
I'm telling you.
Oh my God. Okay, because I don't sing often.
No, we can try. Voice by your voice. It's beautiful.
Thank you. So I'll try two lines. ये दौलत भी ले लो ये शोहरत भी ले लो भले छीन लो मुझसे मेरी जवानी मगर मुझको लौटा दो बचपन का सावन वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी मोहल्ले की सबसे निशानी पुरानी वो बूढ़ी आज से बच्चे कहते थे नानी वो नानी की बातों में परियों का ढेरा वो चेहरे के झुरियों में सदियों का पेरा भुलाए नहीं सकता है कोई वो छोटी सी रातें वो लंबी कहानी वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी वो कागज की कश्ती वो बारिश का पानी
Beautiful, Shri.
That was super.
Thank you so much.
Very beautifully sung and a great selection of a song. My God, thank you. Very beautiful.
Thank you so much.
I would like to ask, which song is that? I love the lyrics. If you could tell me the name.
This is Jagjeet Singh's song. If you just type Kagaz Ki Kashti, you will get a whole lot of options from which Jagjeet Singh is all of Jagjeet Singh is there.
All right, thank you. Actually, I myself am a huge fan of old songs. So it was wonderful.
Yeah, I've listened to Jagjeet Singh. He's very good.
You have such a clear, crisp voice.
Yeah,
such a lovely voice you have.
Thank you so much. Because I think for the last 6 months, I have not even hummed a song.
Yeah, well, the last 6 months have done a lot of things to us, to our minds.
I think so.
So but it's fine. I think today is a good day to start again.
No, but I've skilled the art of jharu and pocha.
All of us have, believe me, all over the world.
Yeah. Thank you.
And we have some skills. We have some skills coming out of our husbands as well, so which has been a great thing. It has been a shocker. In a good way.
Hi, hi. Mona Lisa.
Yeah, hi, Purnima.
As beautiful as her name is her personality.
Thank you so much. It was indeed a pleasure to be here. And I could witness amazing work of arts by so many beautiful work, young ones and others. I feel truly honored, Poornima, that you invited me to be here and to watch. Thank you so much. And to everyone, Poornima is not only my friend, she is my guru, she is my mentor. I'm a holistic healer and I'm a passionate singer too. I sing a lot.
We got to.
See, I'm not an artist. I don't paint, but I wish my daughter was an amazing artist. She doesn't do anymore. But I always had interest in art when I was very little, but I was not really good at it. For me, art in any form is an expression. Expression of your thoughts, your emotions, and whatever comes to your mind. For me, singing is very therapeutic because every time I sing, I have to sing every day. It's like a passion in me. And I am completely transported in another zone. That's like my love, along with the work I do, which Poornima already knows what I do. So singing is something gives me a lot of joy and happiness. That's what.
So I know, Mona, we are heading to you. We want to hear you too.
I'm not really prepared now, but maybe I can sing two lines. I love many songs of Lata, Kishore and Asha. I'm a big Bollywood Gana fan.
Very well too. Wow, you dance very well too.
Yes, that's my, I was coming to it, singing, dancing, reading books, all this thing is my passion. I really enjoy. And yes, I'm a lover of art, though I can't paint to save my life, but I appreciate good art. So I'll just sing two lines, not much. Naam gum jayega, chehra ye badal jayega, meri aawaz hi pehchaan hai, ghar yaad rahe. वक्त के सितम कम हसी नहीं ओ आज है यहाँ कल कहीं नहीं वक्त के परे अगर I don't remember the lines exactly. Meri aawaz hi pehchaan hai, ghar yaad rahe. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Lovely song. मैं बोल रही थी मोना, मैं words बोल रही थी तुमको.
thank you, Sajan ji. Thank you, Shri. Thank you, Poornima. Thank you, Shri. It was truly amazing. And Sajan ji also, amazing singer. It yes. was good to see the mix of art and music.
That's also thank an art. You. That's why. Yeah.
thank yes. you so much. I also want to mention I'm very passionate about photography as well.
Oh, that's wow.
That's my other love.
Wow.
Very nice.
Thank you so much.
Also, Jaya, Huma, and Nirja are unable to connect. They did connect in between, but then I think their videos are not working for some reasons. But that's okay. Next time we have good, we have more space, and next time we'll have lots more artists with us. And thank you all so very much, and for taking our
time. Thank you, guys. Thank you all.
Thank you, Poornima.
Thank you,
all of you.
Thanks, Poornima. This was a fantastic podium to meet all new artists from all over the world. Really appreciate you putting this together. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Poornima, after the lockdown, I'll come and sit with you how to like understand the canvas post the lockdown.
You're so good. I should learn from you. You're very good.
I still need to learn so many things. I don't understand how to actually select that canvas and colors and that. There are so many basics you need to understand. If you really want to do something good, you have to learn what I believe.
Gargi? Hasrat, please unmute Gargi.
Yeah, I just was suggesting that why don't you have a workshop somewhere and where we film live? I mean, we get together, exchange ideas, you know.
You think I can teach? No, I don't teach, but yeah, for sure I can.
I'm not saying you're teaching us, going to teach me. I'm just like, need to understand something.
Yeah, sure, of course. Anytime. Gargi, you're right next to me, so it's not an issue. And
Kumar, let's train together so we can learn from each other. And the young girls are so inspirational.
Yeah, so sure. And Kumar, just...
Yeah, I've been also into kind of writing poetry. I was like kind of wanting to share, but we'll do that next time.
Okay. You have it around you, and if everybody is okay.
Well, that those are very quite long ones, but some are. This I'll have few stanzas from one of my poems. Are you okay to go with it? Galloping with the northwest wind, mind holding on to the riding night. The long coat rustles the iron sword. I glide far with the chopping board. The fears of the wild fires the stove. I look for the knife to kill the boar. I roast the pumpkin to perfection. Far in the sky, the vultures soar. I gallop with the northwest wind. My tresses cloak me around. The drizzle on my forehead I swipe. The sweat taste the desert sand. The sky is brighter than the red. The blue is flaming up. The tomatoes are smoking well. Salsa and tango sing in trump. Far the whistle blows, race to begin. Come home, come home, come home. The clutter and the clatter knocks me in. And there is much more.
Great. Outstanding. Wow. Fantastic.
Very nice.
Hello.
Yeah. Lovely.
Wow.
Thank you.
I see you almost every day on our walks, and I didn't know you write such good poetry too. Awesome.
That's just like, you know, while cooking from the kitchen or, you know, doing the daily chores, something comes into my mind and I write it on.
Thank you. Thank you all so much. It was a pleasure having you all over, and thank you once again. Bye.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Mona.
Thank you,
Sri. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.